Elizabeth Taylor once said, "You can't possess radiance. You can only admire it." She said it better than that. And today, the world that so admired her is mourning the death of Hollywood's first million-dollar actress. Elizabeth Taylor was 79. She was a two-time Academy Award winner who rose to fame as a child, really, starring in the 1944 classic National Velvet. Also among her more than 50 films, Cleopatra, Butterfield 8, and Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I'm loud, and I'm vulgar, and I wear the pants in the house because somebody's got to.
Over the years, Liz Taylor became as famous for her stormy personal life as for her queen on-off talent. She was married 8 times and battled alcohol, drugs, and other health problems. She made a fortune as one of the first celebrities to release a fragrance and spent millions on jewelry, art, and charities, including AIDS research. Trace Gallagher, live in Los Angeles, with more on Liz Taylor's life. Hey, Trace.
You know, Shep, after being hospitalized for 6 weeks, today Liz Taylor died of congestive heart failure. She was surrounded by her 4 children. She was a star at 12 years old, a divorcee at 18 years old, and a widow at 26. And now at 79, she leaves a lasting legacy.
Like riding a fairy horse.
It was National Velvet that made her an American treasure. Black hair, porcelain skin, violet eyes. The magical movie star mix of beauty and ability.
As an almost all Greek thing, I'm flattered.
She was a starlet who stole hearts of millions of fans and many men, 7 of whom she married. Hotel king Conrad Hilton, pop idol Eddie Fisher, movie star Richard Burton, construction worker Larry Fortensky. It was once said Liz Taylor added sweetness to scandal, glamour to gossip.
Elizabeth Taylor was someone that we all followed. Every scandal, every love affair, every new necklace, every new ring made news.
You make me sound just awful.
She was the highest paid actress of her time, signing the first ever million-dollar movie deal. But her true fortune came through her lines of jewelry and perfume. At the time of her 7th divorce, her net worth was estimated at $600 million.
Well, I'm not planning on a perfume called divorce.
In later years, she battled her health, her weight, the tabloids. On her very publicized friendship with Michael Jackson, she said, "He gets me, and I get him." She fought for her friends and on behalf of them. When Rock Hudson died of AIDS, she founded the American Foundation for AIDS Research.
The AIDS crisis is not over.
Today, Liz Taylor's 6th husband, the former Senator John Warner, said they were friends to the end, and the tributes continue to pour in tonight, Shep.
Trace Gallagher, great look back. Thanks, Trace.